Good day, my name is Bruce Strober. I'm professor and chair of dermatology at the University of Connecticut Health Center. Today I'll be discussing a paper regarding clinical meaningfulness of complete skin clearance in patients with moderate to severe psoriasis. This concept was discussed extensively in a paper recently published in the July issue of the Journal of the American Academy of Dermatology, the Blue Journal. In essence, this paper examined patients in clinical trials for the IL-17 receptor blocker brodalumab, and whether it made clinical difference if they achieved PASI 75, PASI 90, or full clearance PASI 100, or sometimes PGA 0. Anyone who's a PGA 0 should be a PASI 100, by the way. In the past, the FDA and other regulatory bodies have mandated that drugs purporting to treat moderate to severe psoriasis be first and foremost measured as high achievement of PASI 75, or physician's global assessment, PGA, 0 or 1. They don't have to be 0, 0 or 1. Basically, the FDA is saying if you achieve a PASI 75 or a PGA 0 or 1 as a patient with moderate to severe psoriasis, you are a success story. And we've always wondered, well, PASI 75 is good, is PASI 79 better? And is PASI 100 better than PASI 90 to PASI 99? And now I think we're better able to answer that question because of this particular analysis. Now, how do we measure whether PASI 100 is better than PASI 75? Or whether PGA 0 is better than PGA 1? We do it because we have metrics of quality of life that we can concomitantly utilize in a clinical trial setting. And we also have metrics of symptoms specifically geared towards patients with moderate to severe psoriasis. So our tool to measure quality of life in this study was called the Dermatology Life Quality Index, the DLQI. And the DLQI is simple. It's 10 questions scored 0 to 3 based on symptoms and psychosocial aspects of having skin disease, not psoriasis specifically. That's an important point. The DLQI was established about 25 years ago as a metric for a variety of skin diseases, not just psoriasis, so including acne and atopic dermatitis. But the DLQI still has validity in psoriasis and is really a gold standard quality of life instrument. The other tool we use is called the Psoriasis Symptom Inventory, PSI. That's new. And Amgen developed this basically at the behest of the FDA to measure specifically symptoms that are really aligned with the patient who has psoriasis and their experience. So the Psoriasis Symptom Inventory, in short, is an 8-item quick questionnaire conducted by the patient, measuring symptoms such as flaking, scaling, burning, stinging, itch, pain, bleeding, redness. All of those are measured in this instrument. And the patient basically scores them on a scale. And to be a success in this PSI, you could either be a total 0, and that's called PSI 0. You have no symptoms. Or you could be a composite score of 8 or below. There's two different ways to define success. Obviously, 8 or below is not as good as total 0. So we looked at both. And finally, another aspect of quality of life that was measured in these studies was the number of days during the study the patient was 100% free of symptoms. All right, that's a good measure. Days where people with psoriasis forgot they had psoriasis because they weren't reminded they had psoriasis. And so that was another good way to measure how quality of life was going for patients. And again, we always will correlate regarding objective assessor response, PASI 100, PASI 75, PGA 0 or 1. Here's the nutshell. A greater percentage of patients showing PASI 100, fully cleared, were PSI responders of zero total, were DLQI responders of zero or one, were more likely to have many more 100% symptom-free days when compared to people who were PASI 90 to 99. So you would think a person PASI 90 to 99 would be just as good as a person as a PASI 100, but you would be wrong. On average, there's a difference. And clearly, PASI 100 patients do better than PASI 75 patients. So the findings here from this study demonstrate clearly that PASI 100 is a relevant clinical endpoint in that it discriminates between people who are really happy symptom-wise and quality of life-wise and only somewhat happy. People who are PASI 100 are more often doing well symptoms-wise and quality of life-wise. And of course, that's intuitively correct. There should be no doubt that 100% clearance more often leads to happier patients on all aspects of their quality of life. But it should be emphasized that, in my opinion, this shouldn't be the ultimate treatment goal. In other words, you're not failing the patient if you don't get them to PASI 100. We all know that certain patients are happy at PASI 75, but not PASI 90. Certain patients are actually happy at PASI 60, PASI 50. It will be still patient specific. When we do these studies, we're looking at populations, and on average, we can make comments about PASI 100 being better than PASI 75. And also, there are other issues that surround the concept of complete clearance. One, if clearance, complete clearance, comes at a price that really offsets the benefit, then it's not a good idea. So, for example, if complete clearance means less safety, then we have a problem. Now, the one good news about the new biologics, the IL-17 inhibitors and some follow-on drugs that are coming down the line, is they actually clear people with really great tolerability and very little or unable to measure safety problems. So reality has it that the new biologics, being so specific and hitting the right targets, might be just as safe as the older biologics, might be safer. It's left to be seen, yet clear patients better. That's a sea change advance in our therapy. The newer biologics, though, might be costlier. They might be less tolerable. They might require more follow-up visits. It's left to be seen there. I'm not seeing that, but obviously if that were the case, clearance comes at too great a cost, and we might want to revert back to the older drugs, which are easier. I again will close by saying the issues will not likely be convenience, will not likely be dosing regimens or tolerability. They all look good for the new biologics. It's going to come down to cost and access. And reality has it, it's going to come down to comfort of patients and their treatment practitioners with new drugs. My analogy is this. Of course, PASI 100 and PASI 90, for that matter, will become new standards. It's inevitable over the next decade. Much like we all have better smartphones than we did 10 years ago. And we would never go back to our smartphone from 10 years ago. Or we have better cars than we had 10 years ago. Even though the cars of 10 years ago were fine, the cars now are better. They have more features. They have GPS. They have cameras that allow you to back up more comfortably. They have lane change sensors to tell you when you're about to sideswipe somebody. All these are features we are now going to take for granted and will never want to lose in cars going forward. The same with biologic therapy for psoriasis. The old drugs were very good. The new drugs are great and don't appear to be coming at a cost. And from that point of view, I think we need to accept that higher levels of clearance will be acceptable and really, in most cases, demanded by both practitioners and their patients.